Journey to space is no longer a dream. Very soon, the general public will be able to fly to space and spend holidays and book vacations there, thanks to the Orbital Assembly's Voyager station. The space construction firm has announced the opening of the world's first ever space hotel in 2027. So, hey guys, welcome back to Curious Minds. And today, we will be seeing about the world's first space hotel. So, let's get on to the video. The Voyager space station is proposed space station, which aims to be the first commercial space hotel. Construction of the space station is planned in 2026. The station will create the artificial gravity using centrifugal force, and the hotel will be built in a Ferris wheel shape. It will be spinning in the simulated gravity in its pods. The Voyager space station has its amenities and rooms at the space hotel, which will be more or less similar to the Earth. As per the station, the hotel will have duplex accommodations up to 280 guests. Not only this, there will be villas too for buying for proposed vacation homes. The hotel will also feature a gym, bar, gourmet restaurant and an entertainment center. It was in 2019 the plans for making a space hotel was first revealed by Von Braun Rotating Space Station. The opening date earlier was 2025, but the dates were postponed due to the ongoing. The company cleared that the delay happened because of the COVID-19 and not any technological holdups. So now let's see what is space tourism. Space tourism is a human space travel for recreational purposes. There are also several different types of space tourism, including the orbital, suborbital, lunar space tourism. To date, orbital space tourism has only been performed by the Russian Space Agency. Work also continues towards developing suborbital space tourism vehicles. This is being done by aerospace companies like Blue Origin, Virgin Galactic. In addition, SpaceX announced in 2018 that they are planning on sending space tourists, including Yasuka Maezawa, on a free return trajectory around the moon on a starship. Now, let's see about the suborbital space tourism. Scaled composite won 10 million X Prize in October 2004 with Spaceship One as first private company to reach and surpass an altitude of 100 km twice within 2 weeks. The altitude is beyond the Kármán line, the ultimately defined by the boundary of space. The first flight was flown by Michael Mayville in June 2004 to a height of 100 km, making him the first commercial astronaut. Prize-winning flight was flown by Brian Bainey, who reached a flight height of 112 kilometers, breaking the X-15 record. Now, the Virgin Galactic aspires to be one of the first offered to regular suborbital space flights to paying passengers abroad. A fleet of 5 Spaceship Two class space planes, the first of these space planes, VSS Enterprise, was intended to commence its first commercial flights in 2015. Tickets were on sale at a price of $200,000, later raised to $250,000. However, the company suffered a considerable setback when the Enterprise broke up over the Mojave Desert during the test flight in October 2014. Over 700 tickets have been sold prior to the accident. A second space plane, VSS Unity, has begun testing. So hey guys, hope you enjoyed this video. If you don't forget to hit the like button, and for more videos don't forget to subscribe to Curious Minds. And if you want to go to the space station, please do comment below. Yes, so until a good video, this is me, Curious Minds, signing off. Bye.